Today, we shall deal with the topic Code of Ethics for Coaches. As you all know it, the coaches are to work in a varied occasion, in a different phase, different fields. So, they are supposed to be very careful because whenever they are stepping into the field of coaching, they are in public eyes. So whatsoever they are doing, their movement, their action, their behavior, all are subject to a criticism or analysis, or people used to discuss about them. They are very conscious about a coach. Unlike other professions, in this profession also, the coaches are supposed to abide by certain guidelines. Otherwise, the coaches normally enjoy freedom while discharging his duties as a coach. In fact, the coaches are required to undergo a training which is known as professional training. Means they are being professionally prepared, trained to discharge their duties in an effective manner. So, whenever the team is getting success, sometimes the coaches might be going beyond control and he may be behaving in a different way which is not acceptable in the society. So, he must have to follow certain guidelines, certain principles which in fact are the guidelines for the coach to follow. And this helps him to work in a much better way, much acceptable way, without creating any confusion in the mind of either the players or other organizers or the officials. And he must also maintain a standard of his behavior while dealing with other people so that he can earn respect from each and everybody. That means he should be acceptable to the society. The coach as an individual, in fact, is a very respectable person, is a very important individual in the society. And as a professional head of the team, he is discharging his duty as a coach for the welfare of the players as individual as well as a team. There is a question again comes in frequently about the coaching, whether it is an art or it is science. In fact, the coaching is an art based on science or scientific principles. But still, there is a difference between two coaches. This is due to the not only the individual differences, but also for the differences as far as their knowledge, experience and the conviction. And that is the reason why two different coaches, they are approaching to their job in a different way. But the purpose of both the coaches are the development or improvement of the players individually and collectively as a team. All these principles, whatever they are following, should have some scientific background, or they must follow certain scientific principles which are been adopted, applied by some other coaches also, and they got the result. Now this is to be practiced on his players and see how it works. If it is effective, yes, he should accept it. If it is not, he should discard it. So, there lies the difference between two individual coaches. Now, each individual has his own conviction, values, ideals, mostly based on the environment he grows and the activity or the profession he is assigned to. So this environment or this society also has got some influence on the personality of that coach or the behavior of the coach or the approach of that coach. Implementing the knowledge methodically into action can be considered a moral issue and may be termed as professional ethics. One must not violate that ethics under any circumstances. And once that ethics are framed, that is the codes, is not for ever. We, all the coaches, must be ready to upgrade those codes, modify those codes for the greater interest of the profession as well as for the players. We must not be prejudiced. So once that code is there, I am following it. This is not to follow the codes, but it is for the greater interest of the profession and also for the players. In fact, a professional person, who is a professional? A professional is a person who is earning his livelihood from that profession or from that work he is performing or the job he is assigned to. The term also refers the capability to discharge duties efficiently. We cannot compromise with the efficiency of an individual. The coach also must be efficient for this job for which he is assigned. The coach should be a role model. It is expected that the players will follow his coach. Normally the players treat the coach as their idols. So he must not do anything which affect that impression. Consistent standard of personal behavior must earn respect from all concerned, including the players. Now, personal appearance, as we have discussed, is of course a matter of personal taste. But the coach has the obligation, moral obligation, to project an image of sound health. He should have a sound health. A coach, normally, it is expected that he should be fit to run or to perform his activity, to discharge his duties efficiently, should not be fat. Then the cleanliness, he should maintain neat and clean. That will inspire his players also to be neat and clean. And he must have the functional efficiency. It is natural that everybody expect from the coach that his team should win, because there cannot be second thought of it. But it cannot be the only motto for a coach. Only winning cannot be a motto. Yes, it is our aim to prepare a winning team, but not at the cost of their studies or their moral character. Because winning is one thing that will not meet the all costs, all what you call the requirements of the players. As I said earlier, unlike other professions, the coaches also must follow certain guidelines, certain ethics, certain principles which are known as code of ethics. Because a coach enjoys the authority while handling the team, and consequently he must also follow certain guidelines based on ethics, may be termed as code of ethics. Now, this ethics, not for the profession alone, this ethics may be in general for the players, means ethical behavior or ethical approach towards players, towards self and society and others. First, we'll discuss about the code of ethics in general. A coach should play a vital role of ethics in football. All of his decisions, actions have ethical implications. The concept of ethics is the attitude of the coach that reflects in the behavior of players under his charge. Now, this attitude should always be positive and for the interest and benefit of the players and the team as well. If his attitude is negative, automatically that will reflect in the mind of the players and their actions and reactions will also be negative. And as a consequence, the entire environment will be spoiled wherever they are practicing or wherever they are participating in any tournament. So always maintain a positive attitude. The coach is therefore should be very careful to the moral aspects of his conduct. He must not behave in such a way that creates problem not only for him but also for other fellows, organizers or match officials and all this, those who are connected with the match or those who are connected with the organization. Participation in sports does not necessarily guarantee that there will be a success or all the players will be reaching to elite level. A couple of years back there had been a study in Germany and they come to a conclusion after the study that only 14% people used to reach in the elite level. And what about the other 86% of people? They are not progressing or becoming elite level of players, but they remain the citizen of the country. So, in addition to making a players to the elite level, we must also ensure that those who are not becoming or improving up to the level of their expectation, or they are not reaching in the elite level, they should be established in the society as a good human being and a fit person in the society. Welfare and moral education of young people should be a priority that before winning a tournament, because we are not only concerned about the team, we must also be concerned about the society and the nation as well. Because a player may not excel as a football player, but at least he should be educated enough to be fit in the society and he should be a respectable person of the society. A coach is to discharge his duties with objectivity, due diligence and professional care in accordance with the professional standard. The coach shall uphold the honor and dignity of the profession. Coaches must uphold the dignity of each player and treat equally irrespective of caste, creed and quality of the individual player. Always, effort must be made to maintain that dignity. Every individual has his own dignity and that is a reciprocal one. If we give due respect to the person or a player, even though he is not very important person in the team, in turn, we will also get respect and there will be a healthy atmosphere within the camp or within the team. The coach shall serve in the interest of the players and team in a lawful manner while maintaining highest ethical conduct and moral character. Coaches must place the well-being and safety of each player above the improvement of performance. The coach shall be aware that he has a tremendous influence for either good or ill in educating the players and shall never place the value of winning above the value of instilling the sportsmanship. What is that sportsmanship? We must not take that at any cost we should win. Winning is important, no doubt. We must try our level best, try hard to win. Similarly, we must also give equal chance for opponents to win it. So it is a challenge, it is a competition. Whosoever is excelling or whosoever is playing better, he should win. And we must accept it. Means play a fair game and give a fair chance to the opponent. That should be our motto. That help us to create an environment which is healthy and sportsmanlike. Coaches must neither use nor tolerate inappropriate words. Under any circumstances, the coach must not retaliate and use some objectionable words, because we are dealing with human being and we feel that the players are also from a respectable family. So their dignity must be maintained. We must not use any language, even out of slip of tongue, towards the players. This is not acceptable and this is not encouraged. Coaches must create an environment conducive for coaching and develop appropriate working relationship with each player based on mutual trust and respect. You know it. If you pay respect to somebody, in turn you should expect a respect. If you don't give it, today maybe out of compulsion somebody is paying respect to you, but it is not from his heart. Unless we can develop a mutual respect between the players and the coaches, then the environment will not be healthy or conducive for improving the performance or continuing the coaching activity. The players should be systematically prepared for the activity and made aware of their own behavior and performance. That means the player should be made to understand that they are responsible for their performance. We are only, as a coach, we are only helping them, only guiding them. But actual improvement will have to be done, will have to be initiated from the player's side. So that is, the players are to be made to understand. For this, the activity undertaken should be suitable for the age, physical and emotional maturity, experience and ability of the performers. So according to their level, whatever the curriculum we are designing or preparing, that must fulfill the requirement of the players. Coaches should clarify exactly what is expected from the players. Means, as a coach, what he is expecting from the players. Side by side, he must also say what he is going to give. That means, what are the expectations of the players from the coach? It should be very, very clear. Coaches should seek the help of sports sciences or sports specialists as and when it is required. There is no harm for the interest of the players. Even a coach is approaching to a person who is more knowledgeable, who can help, who can guide in a better way for the interest of the players. We must not be prejudiced that I know, whatever I know is the best. No, not at all. We must approach, we must keep our doors open for others or the knowledgeable persons or the experts who can help us, who can guide us, who can contribute for the interest of the team or even individual players. Coaches must always encourage players to be disciplined, advocate fair play and guide to abide by the laws of the game. It is mandatory for all. Otherwise, we will have to face the punishment or legal actions. Coach should take an active role in ensuring a conducive and unique surrounding to keep the players away from taking any prohibited drugs or performance enhancing substances or any unhealthy activities. Because many players, even though they are excelling, but ultimately due to that drug, the entire team gets collapsed and also we are earning bad name for the country. I just want to mention one name, not to criticize anybody. In 80s, so the coaches should be alert and always keep vigilance that no one is addicted to taking any drugs or any performance enhancing substances. The coach must avoid the use of alcohol and tobacco, particularly when he is in touch with the players. Coaches must refrain from advocating measures that could constitute unfair advantage either for himself or for the players. A coach must not attempt to exert undue influence on the players in order to obtain personal benefit, nor he should approach the faculty members for undue favor of any player. That means neither he should have any influence on the player for his personal benefit, nor he will approach somebody or some faculty members or the supporting staffs or the organizers for any undue help to any individual. Coaches should aim to provide a safe and enjoyable environment where children and young players are placed at the center of all activities. Encourage and be positive during sessions so that the players live with a sense of achievement. This is for the players. As a coach, always we must give priority or utmost importance towards the players, because players are the prime community for us. Since players are there, the coaches are there, so we are to do everything for the interest of the players. And while the players are leaving the camp or moving from the field, they should have a feeling of gaining or learning certain new things. Set means a coach should set a challenging but realistic, achievable goal. Plan and prepare each session appropriately and ensure proper levels of supervision. We are planning, designing, and implementing the exercises, but not without supervision. We must always supervise whether everything is going on as per the plan or not, whether there is any problem in implementing that one. If at all it is there, that problem should be sorted out as early as it is possible. Now, the personal information of the players be used. As a coach, we used to collect several informations about a player to come to know exactly what is his status, present status, what was his past performance, how much he is progressing, and all other relevant information about an individual player. That information should be used only for preparing a training plan, monitoring the training plan, or for the interest of the players. It is to be used for regulating his training program, so that ultimately we are using this information for the interest of the players. And that information should be kept secret. It should not be disclosed, or nor it should be used for any other purpose whatsoever. Only thing, this information are relevant for the players and we must use it only for the players, not for any other purpose. We must not disclose it to any other agencies or any other individuals unless and otherwise we are forced by the situation. The coach shall exert his influence to follow the rules of proper sportsmanship and respect the dignity of his players as well as opposition. The opponents, those who are playing, they are playing as opponents, they are not enemies. They are also giving us certain lessons how to improve. The more opposition we are getting, more we are getting a chance to think how to overcome it, how to improve our performance. So this is, we should take it in a very positive way so that we can dominate over our opponents. So we must have a respect not only for our own players but also for the players who are playing as opponents today. It may so happen tomorrow some of the players of opponent team will be switching to our team. It may so happen. So players are always a friend and they should be treated as friends. The coach shall thoroughly apprise the competition rules to the players. If there is a change other than the FIFA established rules, if there may be certain changes for that particular tournament. The coach must apprise all the players about the competition rules thoroughly. The coach shall not seek an advantage by circumventing the spirit or letter of the laws of the game. Now, if you go through the laws of the game, you will find the players are also being punished, circumventing the laws of the game. In that connection, I would like to give you one example of 1966 World Cup, as you all know it. What happened there? The England team was winning by 1-0 till the last moment. The supporters and the spectators were just in the mood to celebrate their first World Cup champion. But at the just dying moment, the goal was equalized by a controversial goal. Hence, there was a lot of problem. The players of England team refused to play. And they all came near the sideline, that is the touchline. And all these persons engaged in the organizing the tournament approached the players, but they were not in a mood to play. Then the coach or the manager of the England team in 66 World Cup, Sir Alf Ramsey, he came out and he said to the boys, "Well, you have already won the tournament. I want to see that you win it again." Only this much he said, nothing else. The players went to the field, they played, and ultimately they won by 3-1. So that was the impact of the voice or the confidence bestowed by the coach. And the players proved it. Yes, they are ready for that one. So the coaches must deal opponents with due respect, both in victory and defeat. The coach should encourage his players to act in a similar manner. Educate the players to be modest in victory and accept defeat graciously. The coach shall respect and cooperate with match officials. This is a courtesy. If we blame the match officials, we must also understand the match officials are also human beings. And they are only supported by their fellow match officials. Because the spectators, they are divided into two groups, either A or B. And nobody is supporting the referee or the match officials. And continuously they are running as close to the ball as possible, without any gap, without any pause. So in the process, as human being, they are also likely to commit certain mistakes. This is human error. The coach shall not indulge in provoking his players or spectators against the officials. Always we must cooperate as coaches to the match officials, because they are trying their level best to do justice. But situation is such, sometimes they may commit a mistake, but that should not be an issue. It should be taken sportingly. Criticizing match officials or blaming the players shows his inefficiency as a coach and taking the shelter of excuses. This should not be done. Now, while maintaining the relation with the media people, all his decisions should be within the rules of the game. Every effort must be made to abide by high principles that promote mutual respect between the coach and the spectators or officials. The coach should meet and exchange cordial greetings. This is obligatory on the part of the coaches to meet the coach of the opponent team before the commencement of the game and after the commencement of the game. This is a courtesy call. It must be maintained. This gives a healthy environment and gives impression, good impression, sportsmanly impression to all those who are spectators, officials, or the organizers. Even the players also learn some certain things, how to maintain a cordial relation even with the coach of the opponent team. On principle, medication and treatment should be administered only by the medical officer, that too registered or qualified medical officer. We as coaches must not take any chance to prescribe or advise any medicine to any player without the consultation of the doctor. qualified doctor I am talking about. However, in case of emergency, yes, we as coaches must know to give the first aid treatment to the players. Use courtesy, honesty and respect in all dealings with the media. Coaches should restrict their players to reflect proper conduct when being interviewed by the media. That is also to be taught. Comments about upcoming game should be limited to promoting the contest only. And these comments or anything remarks should be passed only with the players for inspiring the players so that the players are doing their best, not for any other reason. Coaches will maintain professionalism while predicting outcome of any match. Thank you very much.